Hi, and welcome to our visit to the beautiful historic town of Rye in East Sussex. I really hope you like what we put together here. Why not subscribe so you don't miss any of our future travels? Rye can be found in the southeast corner of the UK, in the county of East Sussex. If you're in the area, then why not check out Hastings, Battle and Winchelsea? But today we're here to take a look at the historic ancient St. Paul town of Rye. The fastest rail route from London is via London St. Pancras and takes around about an hour and 15. And if you're driving, there are planned display car parks dotted around town, but they can get busy. So without further ado, let's explore historic Rye and that Landgate. And it's the last of the town's surviving gates, the others being Strand Gate, Baddings Gate and Postern Gate. And this impressive structure dates from 1329. And as I mentioned, Rye is part of the ancient St. Paul's Confederation, receiving its royal charter in 1289. And it would be fair to say that over the following centuries, it's had a checkered history. And as we climb East Cliff, we take a look out over the landscape, and most of this would have been underwater in the 12th and 13th century, with easy access to the English Channel. We'll be returning to the Landgate a little later, but for now let's head up East Cliff and around the corner towards the High Street. And the High Street is a unique blend of independent shops, and there's plenty of restaurants, cafes and places to make sure you're kept fed and watered. And it has a look of somewhere that hasn't changed in years, but we've visited many times and shops come and go. And make no bones about it, Rye is a tourist town, and there are plenty of opportunities for you to spend your hard-earned pounds. And there speaks the voice of experience. But don't get me wrong, I love exploring Rye. And that's what we're going to do now. We're going to head up East Street, but don't worry, we'll be back along the High Street a little later. There's plenty more for us to discover. And you do feel Rye has history around every corner, with little nooks and crannies to be explored. To our right is the Rye Castle Museum, which is open from April until October every weekend. And as we climb East Hill, we pass modern restaurants and head up towards the former home of Paul Nash, the English surrealist artist who lived here from 1928 to 1933. And as we head through town, we'll be meeting some other famous names as we go. Looking back down East Street, you'll get to understand that Rye isn't that big a place you can easily visit on a day trip, but we recommend you stay a little bit longer. And as we round the corner into Market Street, we spot that the tower of the Town Hall is being restored. But before we get to the Town Hall, let's take a quick look along Church Square. Don't worry, we'll be back here a little later, I promise you. So let's head towards that town hall. Built in 1742 by Andrew's Jelf, and the third one to be built on this spot, the first one being burnt down by the French in raids during the Hundred Years' War. And it's to the town hall you come for visitor information. I guess when the restoration work is done, it'll look as fabulous as ever. And as we reach the end of Market Street, we're going to turn up Lion Street towards the Church of St. Mary's. And now we've rejoined Church Square. And are you enjoying it so far? Leave us a comment, we'd love to know. And walking around the churchyard, we head to the town's war memorial with the Ypres Tower in the background. And this is a view of Church Square we saw earlier. And it's along here you'll discover the water tower that was built around 1735. And Church Square runs all the way around the church, with the church being at the centre of it. But we're now going to head off towards the Ypres Tower, or to give it its original name, the Baddings Tower, and it's close to here we would have found one of the other town's original gates, the Baddingate. And in 1430 it became the property of John de Ypres and picked up its latest name, although it's also known as Rye Castle. And in front of it, the Gun Garden, with views over what would have been the coastline. It's now 2 miles further out that the sea begins. It was in the 13th and 14th century that some severe storms changed the landscape forever. A similar story to that of Winchelsea. Did you catch our video on that? I'll pop the link up at the very end. And just to the side of Ypres Castle is the Ypres Castle Inn, a great historic pub offering a selection of fine ales with its fabulous beer garden. I have to say, if you're in Rye and you like a pub, you're spoilt for choice. And now we return to Church Square, and we're on the southern side, next to the Church of St Mary's, Rye. And I guess this is the most historic part of the town, with these buildings dating back to the 15th or 16th century. Now let's take a stroll and have a look. And it's hard to believe these buildings have stood since the time of the Tudors. And it was Queen Elizabeth I who gave the town the right to use Rye Royal after a visit in 1573. It's along here you'll find the old stone house, built in 1263, burnt out by the French in 1377, and modernised in 1889. And now we reach the corner of Church Square on Watchbell Street, and that will lead you to the Hope Anchor pub. But no, not yet. We're going to be heading around Church Square. You feel there's a certain sense of pride in Rye. Everything just looks rather neat and tidy. Now we're heading down West Street towards the National Trust owned Lamb House. And behind that wall are the rather splendid gardens of Lamb House, enjoyed by E.F. Benson and Henry James. And it was here E.F. Benson wrote the Map and Lucia novels, based in the fictional Tillings, which I think we all know is Rye, and it's why the TV adaptations were filmed here. West Street will lead us all the way back down to the High Street, but we're not interested in that, because on our left is Mermaid Street. It's said to be one of the most Instagram streets in all of England. I'm not sure. What I do know is it's damn pretty. And it's also home to the Mermaid Inn. The Mermaid Inn has stood on this spot since about 1156, although this is the modern version, rebuilt in 1420. And I have to say, the Mermaid is a firm favourite. And you'll see why in a second. And you can see why this place is so popular. It's as pretty as a peach, but I can hear the mermaid with her siren song calling me. So after some negotiations with Janice about who's going to drive home, it's time to visit the Giant's Fireplace Bar. It's here where smugglers in the 18th century, like the Hawkhurst gang, would have met to discuss their nefarious deeds. And behind us is a priest hole from the times of the English Reformation. Today the clientele are just a little bit more genteel. The Mermaid Inn is a cornerstone of Rye, so I definitely recommend popping in for whichever refreshment takes your fancy. Having had a thoroughly wonderful time in the Giant's Fireplace Bar, we head out and discover The Smuggler's Song by Rudyard Kipling. He only lived 20 or so miles from here at Bateman's. Did you catch our video on that? I'll pop a link in the corner. Anyway, it's time to discover more of Rye before the sun finally sets. it's back onto Mermaid Street, admiring the view and heading downhill. Here's where one or two too many at the Mermaid Inn may prove to be your undoing. Take care. When you get to the bottom of Mermaid Street, don't forget to look back to enjoy it. And now we've reached the Strand. And this would have been close to the original quayside, and where you would have found another one of the town's gates, Strand Gate. Oh, and of course another inn. And the ship inn dates from the early 19th century and includes a warehouse, which is what this whole area would have been made up of. And you can definitely feel this is a transition point for the town. And up on the hill, the old Borough Arms. They do like a tipple in this neck of the woods, don't they? Anyway, the Strand has now become a hub for antiques, collectibles and bric-a-brac. And yes, we've bought something from one of these stores before. They're great to have a look around at. But beware, you may end up with something you really didn't intend. It's also on the Strand that you'll find the Rye Heritage Centre. Well worth popping in if you're interested. Crossing the road, you'll come across the River Breed, and this flows into the River Rother. And at the very end there is a great fish and chip shop, Kettle of Fish. Pick up a bag, take a seat, and fight off a seagull. A great British pastime. We head back on the Strand, past the Ship Inn, and head towards the Mint. This road will now take us up towards the High Street, past another inn, and a rather fabulous fish and chip shop. If you don't fancy a fight with a seagull, then why not take a table at Marino's? Another of Rye's historic pubs, the Old Bell Inn. Once again frequented by smugglers in the 18th century, and there's said to be a secret tunnel running between here and the Mermaid Inn. Oh, and I know I've pointed out every pub known to man in Rye, but there are plenty of tea rooms, coffee shops, cafes and restaurants in town. Rye to the outsider does seem like an unspoiled gem. And this is Market Road, and it's a 3-minute walk from here down to the railway station. The Rye Bookshop is actually a Waterstones, but haven't they done a great job of making it blend in with the town? Even the town's boot pharmacy looks muted. The old grammar school is now a record store. There are so many original and unique looking stores in Rye. Now, the observant of you may have noticed, we've returned to where we departed the High Street earlier in the clip. But I think the town looks even better as the sun starts to set. What do you think? Is Rye for you? And are you enjoying this? Don't forget to give us a like, it would really help us. And why not subscribe? There's plenty more travels planned. And our journey out of town takes us back along the High Street and down East Cliff. Although now the sun is setting over town, it looks rather magnificent. And one of the things I didn't get a chance to point out on the way up is the building to the right is the old forge, and I could take the path now on my right hand side, but there's something magical about the Landgate, so guess what, one more time through I go. And I learned something new. I didn't know the Landgate also had a drawbridge in front of it too. And as I draw this video to a close, I do need to point out there's more of the town to see. We just ran out of time. But I'd just like to say thanks so much for watching. Take care, stay safe, and happy travels.